Hey everybody, this is Alex with GuitarForce.com. As you can see from the title, this is going to be a lesson on how to play the first solo from a song called Ocean by Led Zeppelin. A while back ago I made a lesson explaining the rhythm guitar for this song, and if you haven't checked it out and you are interested in it, I'm going to post a link down in the description box below and also on the screen so you can go and see the rhythm guitar for this song. I'm going to be also posting another lesson on the second solo, but it's going to be on a separate video, so stay tuned. Also keep in mind that the solo that I've transcribed for this lesson is taken from the live performance, I think it was in 1970 or something like that. You can find it here on YouTube as well. And it's practically the same as the studio version. I would say about 90% of it is exactly the same. So, you know, just keep that in mind. Also, the tabs and the backing track for this lesson are going to be available as usual at GuitarForce.com for free. And while you are there, you can check out the store section and purchase a product, and that way you're going to be supporting me and at the same time getting some quality information. Alright, so back to the lesson. It's in standard tuning, so no need to tune up or down. And yeah, that's it. Without further ado, let's go for the close-up. Take a listen to the solo first, and then we'll start the lesson. Let's check it out. Alright, so the solo starts off with the unison bend, it goes like this. Now here we're going to be playing the B string on the 5th fret and at the same time bending the G string at the 7th fret. And we play it two times, hold it for a while with some vibrato. Then we play the B string again. And while the G string is bent, we hit it again, so bring it down, pull off to 5, so right, and then we play on the G string going 5 to 7 hammer on and playing two more times. So again, the first phrase goes like this, slowly. Next part. Okay, here on the A string we go 5 to 7 hammer on, then we go to D string going 5, G string 5, and back to the D string on the 7th fret, playing it twice. After that we play basically the same lick but going one octave up. But this time starting from the major third in the key of E, we go on the G string 6th fret. So we go 6 to 9, then on the B string we play 8, same on the high E, and back to the B string at the 10th fret. And again playing it twice. So far we got... Then the next phrase, which is staying on the 10th fret of the B string, right, and playing it two times, then playing 8th fret of the high E back to the B string at the 8th fret. So Then we have... Now, this is, you know, just random slides. We can do it on a high E string going somewhere from... While we're here in this position, you know, we can use, let's say, the 10th fret. So we slide it up, right, somewhere here in between, in this area. And when we reach this area, at the same time, we play the B string and slide out. You know, something like that. This is just, you know, for effect. So far we got... Right, the next phrase. Now here, on the B string, we are bending at the 15th fret. One whole step. And while it's bent, we catch with pinky the 15th fret of the high E string and playing it three times while the B string is bent up. Then we play the B string and bring down the bend. Sorry. Then pull off to 13 and finish it off on the G string 14th fret. Alright, so the next lick goes like this. Now here we slide on the G string into the 6th fret, then playing 5th fret of the high E, then we play 8, 5, 8 on the B. And keep in mind that this lick is it's played in a shuffle way, so it's not straight 8s, but it's... Like I said, the shuffle. So after that we have another 5 to 8 on the B string. And then the rest of the lick, which is 5th on the B string. Then we have on the G string bent up at the 7th fret. And then we go right into the 5th fret of the G. To 7 to 5. So. And finish it off on the D string, 7 frets twice. So when we put together two parts, right, one more time. Now, the rest of the solo is practically identical to the first part that we did, which goes... So, basically, he just repeats the same phrases as we did in the first part. Now, when he plays live, this part, he repeats it twice in the solo. However, on the record, on the studio record, I think he does something like... Sorry. Something like that, which is just bending the B string up at the 15th fret and then playing twice on the high E string at the 15th fret. Something like that, if I'm not mistaken. At live, he just plays the same as previously in the first part. Right? After that, we go into the last part of the solo, which is basically follows the verse chords, which are going... Alright? And... he plays some double stops. It goes like this. Okay, so the first double stop is minor third, right? And we are playing G string at the 11th fret and the B string at the 10th fret. Again, playing in the same rhythmical manner as the verse. So, four times. Then we move the same shape two frets down. Then we play, which is now we're playing a major third interval, right? So on the G and the B strings, 7th fret. Then we play the minor third interval, same shape as we did here. So now on the G we have 6, on the B we have 5. And back to the major third interval, G and the B strings at the 7th fret. And back to the first interval that we did in the beginning. So the whole phrase again slowly. Alright, so that's the whole figure of the last part of the solo. Now he plays this part for 4 times, and in between these parts, in live version, he does the, this slide. So let me demonstrate it. The first line goes like this. So basically the first 2 times he plays slide somewhere, I think on the B string, you know, it's just a random slide going up and down. Third time it seems like he's doing a slide out on the A string. It's around 14th fret, something like that. So it would be. So like I said, this figure is played for 4 times. We have slides in between the first 2 on the B string, third one is on the A string, and the 4th time we play this figure, after that he goes into the riff, last part of the riff, of the main riff, right? So you can check that riff out in my lesson where I do the lesson on the rhythm guitar of this song, alright? So basically that's it for this solo. Now I'm gonna play this through the whole solo slower, you know, slowly, so you can hear. And also keep in mind that he's using a wah pedal here, and the wah pedal is used here mostly for creating the tone rather than, you know, going, you know, using the it up and down all the time, but like I said, it's rather for creating the tone, giving it a little bit of high boost and so on. Alright, so now let me do the slow version without the wah, so you can hear just the notes, how they go, and it goes like this. Guys, so that was it for this lesson. I hope you liked the explanation. If you did like this video, please hit the like button. Also, comment, subscribe if you're new to my channel. Don't forget, I'm going to be posting the second solo, the lesson on the second solo, in a separate video, so stay tuned. Don't forget to go to GuitarForce.com for more guitar-related stuff. In the meantime, I'll see you again. Take it easy, and as always, let the force be with you.